got a mystery on our hands this week. The scholars in this room are the crew of the mighty ship, the Envisioneer.
While in search of an ancient treasure, we were marooned on an island, and a key part of our navigational map went missing.
Of the entire crew, we consider four suspects. Today, we'll hear the evidence collected against Dr. Smart and Shipwright Nick.
This week, we learned about splints. So if there is a situation where we need to know how to wrap whatever you broke or fractured, you will be prepared. All body parts need to be wrapped differently, so we will know what to do.
This week we build lung models to help Dr. Smart come up with the best treatment. So we built lung models to better understand the lungs and to know what to do when your lungs collapse.
Go.
My friends and I are going to talk about how we save the crew with our M-Bots. We will be using one of my friend's M-Bots.
This week, we saved the crew by programming our M-Bots to get across the bridge we made because of the big storm that happened.
I will be using my M-Bot and my group's bridge to show you.
This week we learned about snake bites. We learned about neurotoxic and hemotoxic. Hemotoxic affects the blood. Neurotoxic affects your neurons or just the whole body. The hemotoxic can give you heart attacks, blood clots, or may even death. The neurotoxic can affect your body parts and your heart.
This week we learned about snake bites to be safe. There are three types of snake venom: non-venomous, neurotoxic, and hemotoxic. When a hemotoxic snake bites you, it affects your blood. It affects your blood with a blood clot. This week, we mixed milk and lemon juice to recreate the blood clot.
Examining the heart this week, we found out that the heart pumps blood through the body. Cutting in half the heart of a calf, we saw the right and left ventricle. Blood that is not nourished enters the pulmonary artery, which enters to the right atrium, which goes to the right ventricle. Right valves prevent blood from going the wrong way.
Ready, set, go.
After analyzing the blood drops, we realized that the blood came from 30 inches.
Therefore, the blood drops were Neff's, because Neff had a rad scar on his hand, which is roughly 33 inches.
Ready, set, go.
This week, we needed to find out the mystery powder to help Dr. Smart cure the wounds.
We were looking at what they found at the crime scene. We added liquid to the different powders and found out that the mystery powder was cornstarch.
Cornstarch helped Dr. Smart cure the wounds. Also, this week we needed to find out the fingerprints to see who stole the missing piece of the map.
We used cocoa powder to find out who it was. It was Dr. Smart and Ned.
Based on all the evidence our STEM group has submitted, we believe that Dr. Smart and Shipwright Neff are the culprits of stealing the ancient map.